Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that we are studying topic translation. Now translation is a process in which protein synthesis takes place. Let's study how protein is made in human beings. Translation. Translation means the synthesis of protein inside human body or any eukaryote or prokaryotic cell. Now, what are these proteins? An example of proteins could be your insulin, epinephrine, growth hormones. All these are proteins and they have to be formed by the process of translation. Are these proteins important in human life and in your life? Yes, they are very important. So the process of translation does not start on its own or it is the first process. No, it's not like that. First, the process of DNA replication takes place inside nucleus. Then that DNA replicate will form mRNA, which is messenger RNA, which will have information on its strand. And then once mRNA is transcribed, or transcription process forms mRNA along with information that codes for protein, this mRNA is transferred to cytoplasm and now translation takes place. So your mRNA basically serves as a template, or you can say serves as a pass for protein synthesis. How does this process work? mRNA will have information, which is exposed information or exposed base pairs in the nucleotide sequence, and these nucleotides are in the form of codons, especially in the triplet of three codons. The first process that will take place is activation of amino acids. Now, amino acids which are present inside your body or in your diet will be activated, or you can say charged. Next, transfer of activated amino acids with the help of tRNA, or you can say transfer RNA. Now, once activated amino acids are transferred with the help of tRNA, this tRNA will have a anticodon sequence which will bind to the codon region on mRNA. And once this codon anticodon match is done, what you get is the nucleotides, or you can say the amino acid polypeptide sequence is formed. When I say polypeptide, poly means many, and peptide is the bond that's formed when two different amino acids attach together. Once a long chain of amino acids is formed that will together assemble to give us a protein, the chain is terminated. Translation. And when I speak about translation, it is a process by which proteins are formed. The process of synthesis of a protein molecule by using genetic information that is present in the form of codons, especially triplet codons on the mRNA, or you talk about messenger RNA, is called as translation. And this process takes place inside the cytoplasm of a cell. The steps involved are, the first step is activation or charging of amino acids, and we all know amino acids are the smallest units of proteins which are joined together by peptide linkage. Next, the activated amino acids are transferred with the help of tRNA, and we all know tRNA is nothing but transfer RNA. The next process is initiation of the polypeptide chain. And well, I've told y'all that the polypeptide chain is nothing but which is formed after amino acids have linked together. Now, once polypeptide chain has been synthesized, a long chain is formed of polypeptides, and this long chain is nothing but your proteins. And once this is done, the chain basically terminates or stops. Students, this is translation process. Now, this is your mRNA or your messenger RNA. Now, this mRNA or messenger RNA has triplet codons for synthesis of proteins. As you can see, AUC is the first codon that codes for a protein, methionine. Similarly, these are other codons in the form of 3 that codes for protein. To the mRNA, what comes and binds is your ribosomes, which is your rRNA. Now, once ribosomes has binded, ribosomes have P site and A site. The P site is the entry site and A site is the exit site. Your tRNA will carry nucleotides, which are nothing but anticodon. And these anticodons will bind to the codon region to form anticodon and codon complex. Once this is done, what happens is, all the amino acids form a polypeptide chain or a long chain, and this growing polypeptide chain is continuously formed once all the proteins are formed. Once all the proteins are formed, then this chain would be terminated. So the 3 different types of RNA that takes place is mRNA, that's messenger RNA, rRNA, which is ribosomal RNA, and tRNA, which is transfer RNA. And this transfer RNA actually carries your activated amino acid. As you can see, it has carried serine, which is a type of amino acid, all the 20 amino acids. Students, inside body, what we have is 20 different types of amino acids. And all these 20 different types of amino acids join in certain fashion by forming the polypeptide chain. Students, I hope you all have understood that the process of translation is directly dependent on replication, transcription, and then translation. Without transcription, translation cannot take place. Proteins can never be formed if there is no mRNA, rRNA, and tRNA present inside your body. I hope you all are clear with this concept of translation, that is synthesis of proteins. Thank you.